Philippine Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla marks 1 year since his appointment as he nears the end of his term. Medalla feels accomplished that he managed to control the country's surging inflation and depreciating peso. Lady Vicentia tells us more.
With about a month and a few days left in his term as Philippine Central Bank Governor, Felipe Medalla appears content and unconcerned about whether or not he might be reinstated or shown the door.
I don't think about those things. Huh? It's already a great privilege to be able to serve 1 year.
Medalla was appointed by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in May 2022 after then BSP Governor Benjamin Jokno's appointment as Finance Secretary. In his 1 year at the helm, Medalla had to deal with a 14-year high inflation of 8.7% hit last July, an unprecedented monetary policy tightening cycle to wean the Philippine economy off accommodative policies put in place during the pandemic, and a volatile foreign exchange which saw the peso fall to an all-time low against the U.S. dollar. Medalla also inherited an aggressive campaign to bring more Filipinos into the formal banking system through fintech and the internet, including the headaches that came with it, such as cybersecurity problems and high-tech scammers. Medalla has risen to the occasion, with inflation in retreat over the last 3 months and an aggressive multi-sectoral nationwide cybersecurity awareness and education campaign to fight phishing scams. The FinTech Alliance has been a strong supporter of the central bank, and it is optimistic the Philippines' transition toward digital finance will continue regardless of who is in charge at the central bank.
Regardless of who the governor is, BSP has been a staunch ally and a supporter of the FinTech Alliance, that PH, in championing inclusive digital finance. This campaign does not have any timelines or doesn't have any deadline. We've seen a number of cyber attacks, no, cyber crimes being committed, no, and that's why we just have to make sure that every Filipino is knowledgeable about how to detect potential phishing scams.
There are still some things Medalla has to deliver, including a promise made by Jokno to reduce banks' reserve requirement ratio to single digits before the end of his term, which happens in July. Currently, the RRR for big banks is at 12%. Medalla also has one more monetary policy meeting left, scheduled for June 22nd. It will be the fourth rate-setting meeting of the year and possibly the last for Medalla's short term. When asked if he is open to be reappointed,
to be governor of the central bank, an institution I'm very proud of.
Lady Vicentia, ABS-CBN News.
In other news, Philippine senators pass on third and final reading a bill extending the deadline to avail of estate tax amnesty until June 14, 2025. The target date was first extended under the Duterte administration from 2021 to 2023. The bill covers the estates of individuals who died on or before the 31st of May last year. Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno lauds the Senate's move, saying it will enable the government to collect additional revenues and strengthen tax compliance. From the enactment of tax amnesty law in 2019 until March 31 of this year, the state has collected 7.41 billion pesos from over 130,000 estate tax amnesty beneficiaries. Some Philippine senators still don't see the need for a sovereign wealth fund. During Monday's Senate debates on the Maharlika Investment Bill, Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel questioned President Marcos's certification of the measure as urgent. He says it can only be rushed if there's a public calamity or emergency. The president's sister, Senator Aimee Marcos, isn't also too keen on passing it. Key concerns for her are funding and the country's debts.
Kasi ang pagkaintindi ko, nagkakaroon ng sovereign fund kapag nag-jackpot. Pagka nagka-jackpot ang isang bansa, halimbawa, yung Malampaya sana, jackpot yun eh, nagkaroon tayo ng natural gas. Sana noon, nagka-sovereign fund. Sa ibang bansa, pag nakahanap sila ng oil, ayan, jackpot din. Ayun, when you get a windfall, that's usually the beginning of a sovereign fund. Eh, I don't feel any windfall right now. I feel utang.
Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva, however, believes the bill underwent enough scrutiny.
On our end naman sa mayorya, tatlong buwan na pinag-uusapan even before na dumating dito sa Senado itong panukalang batas na ito. Looking at the priority measures of this administration, hindi naman natin inuna itong Maharlika eh. Ito na yung talagang normal course. And now that the President is calling for Congress to pass this measure, so we're here to respond and heed the call of the President.
The period of interpolation is now closed. The period of amendments will resume Tuesday afternoon. Other top government officials meanwhile express support for the Maharlika Investment Fund bill. Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla believes there are enough safeguards within the measure to ensure it won't be detrimental to government's fiscal health. For House Speaker Martin Romualdez, it might play a role in boosting the Philippine stock market.
The bill as it is now is okay. This is no longer a sovereign wealth fund. It's now more a national development fund, right? It's now an investment fund.
The corporation that will be created to manage the Maharlika Investment Fund will value Look PSE in its search for blue chip investment opportunities from which handsome dividends may be generated. Dividends which shall be channeled to the fund of the government's strategic and social programs towards the achievement of the nation's larger developmental goals.
The Philippine Central Bank sees inflation significantly easing in May. Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla says this will put it on track to return to government's four-year target range of 2-4% by the end of the year. The consumer price index eased to 6.6% in April from 7.6% in March. This brought the average for the year at 7.9%. May inflation data is due out next week, June 6th. Here at home, the Philippine government's budget gap settles at 204 billion pesos in April. Year to date, this was less by 107 billion pesos from the same period last year. That's amid a budget surplus last month of 66.8 billion pesos, higher than the previous year's surplus of 4.9 billion pesos, thanks to higher revenue collection. The budget department also reminding government agencies not to underspend. Budget Chief Amena Pangandaman says a faster disbursement of funds also means faster procurement and implementation of government projects. The Budget Department has said utilization rate of government agencies for the first 4 months of the year is at 90%.